up my adolescent fantasies. Hollywood Boulevard, Sunset Boulevard, Grauman's Chinese, the glamour mecca, the mecca of the trade, the very essence of the word, showbiz. Skid Row, Sunset Boulevard was teeming with hookers, and Grauman's Chinese wasn't even called that anymore. Men's Chinese. Doesn't have the same ring, does it? The way that the women's movement was going in 1976, I was absolutely amazed that they didn't insist to be called Person's Chinese. We've got a little bit of a ring here, haven't we? We'll just stop this for a minute. And until this is our lighting and sound man, Mr. Tim Pack, ladies and gentlemen. You think it'll be all right now, Tim? What do you reckon? Can't hear you, Tim.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Where was I? Person's Chinese, that died. Oh, well, I figured I might as well go home. All my dreams were that, just dreams, nothing else. I was a fool to think that an Australian could make it in Hollywood. I'm going to give it up. Wait a minute. Is this the Aussie spirit that's got me this far? Is this the Aussie guts that brought me 10,000 miles? I'll stay on and show them what we Aussies are made of. I'll start a trend. But in the 80s and 90s, I can predict other Australians will come over in waves, singing, dancing, acting, marching up a newly refurbished Hollywood.
Around he
breed to hear him sing. And there were plane tickets, phone calls, money spent to rent the hall, took most of his savings, but he gladly spent them all. I did 42nd Street in Sydney here 2 years ago, but I did it in Texas, Denver, California, and last August I did it in St. Louis with some of the members of the original Broadway cast. And let me tell you, our homegrown stand up very, very well. thing for me to do it because Leroy Reams, who was the original Billy Lawler, told me some of the Broadway production stories. And of course, we just love to hear all the backstage dish. And some of the ones he told me were about Tammy Grimes, who was evidently a very eccentric leading lady. And she was the original Dorothy. Now, if you haven't seen 42nd Street, it's a backstage story set in the 30s where the star, the fading star, breaks her leg on opening night, thus paving the way for the small town girl to take over the role and become a star in her own right. There's a very lovely dressing room scene towards the end where Dorothy comes in to see Peggy, and it looks as though she's going to really rip shreds off her, but what she's really going to do is hand over the mantle to the younger star. And Tammy came in the wheelchair with her beautiful dress and her leg in plaster, and she came and she looked at Peggy and she said, "So you're going to take my place, wearing my songs and singing my costume." Peggy didn't know whether to dance the evening frock or what. But there was a lovely show that I got to do in Sacramento, which we may never see out here, unfortunately. It was called The Mystery of Edwin Drood, and it's now called Drood. Explanation mark. And it was the last unfinished story that Charles Dickens wrote before he died. As a matter of fact, he died while he was writing it, and that was woven into the context of the show. And the musical was done in the genre of the bawdy 19th century English music hall, and I played the part of the evil Princess Puffer, who below the street and beneath contempt ran London's most notorious opium den. But you can't help liking her. Crime don't pay, that's what I tells them. If it did, could I be mixing pipes? What then I sells them for a pint of rotten beer. Throat your cut for bleeding tuppence, then you slacks to get some sleep. Punch your face for bleeding threepence, you disgrace to work so cheap. So I says, don't be a sinner for a pint of London gin. You can't pay for one square dinner with the wages of sin. Sell me soul, oh, love come off it. Who would buy this sack of skin? On the whole, there's not much profit in the wages of sin. In the wages of sin. In the wages of sin. Oh, well, I love fancy seeing you here two nights in a row. You've been buttering up instead of me, eh? What little piece of raspberry tart? Oh, I do beg your pardon, madam. Your first time out with him, is it? Oh, never mind, you have had him on several occasions. And I can tell you what he's got in store for you later, it'll be over in an instant. I see girls from gutter families, trap rich men with fluttery ways, and they say, "Come on, pass the jam, please. Over nuptial breakfast trays. Over here in bed 11 lies a bleeding hypocrite. Spends his days, eyes cast to heaven. Spends his nights amongst this shit." Oh, I do beg your pardon. Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Oh, those words will never, never, that word will never pass my lips again. No, really. Now, where was I? Oh, yes, shit. So I says... So I says... Don't take off measures. Do things right. Dig right in this world. There's better pleasures than the wages of sin. I get friends, seldom offers. If I did, I'd pack it in. You can't fill too many coffers for the wages of sin. show, Princess Piper has a dramatic change of mood when she meets and is reunited with the young heroine, whose nanny she was when the heroine was a little girl. And in a lovely and touching song, she tells her what led her to this life of crime. Chanel, till I met a man, torn old gold peg where my end began. I let him have his way with me, he knew his way so well. Led me down the garden path to hell. Marriage in the end, what I got instead was a bed in Canada. I'll send around a friend, be good to him, this swell. Strolling down your garden path to hell. Make your bed of roses and sleep in it. Come on deep in it and pray. From the seeds of one mistake. I'll be back all day, earning Satan's pay. I took to drink so as not to think of who'd come next to play. I gave my jet my every cent, and he gave me farewell. Leaving me to weed the path to hell. Life's a maze of hedges that prickle you. As they tickle you, they tear you all about. Strolling through the maze can be amusing too, but confusing when you can't find your way out. Lost my looks by then, couldn't draw the men, and so I learned a trade to earn my keep with drugs. And then I found myself a wicked shelf where opium I sell. Here's a pipe for you, sir. Price is 5 and 2, sir. Can't you see the garden? Oh, such a lovely garden. Street upon street of shuttered theatres with police signs on them, and the homeless are moving in and sleeping in the stage doorways. So there are some shows left on Broadway, but the ones that are there all seem to sound the same. Yeah. Well, why not? They have the same composer. Here you go. phantom. One of the nicest things about going to Hollywood was meeting Ron Creager. We've been working together now for 15 years. Ron not only plays piano for me, but he writes for me. We co-compose things. We co-wrote this act together. And when Australia was flavour of the month for about a minute and a half over here, we got asked to do a lot of Australian things. Australia Day is very big on our calendar. We always get to do. So we put together the obligatory waltzing Matilda, Tata, Kangaroo Dance, Puppet No View and all that. But I said, you know, none of these songs really tell the Americans what an Australian is. And he said, well, let's write one. So we did. Which was cut out of the movie. So it's no good getting the video to find out who she was. She ain't in it. But in the original stage show, the part was created by Lotte Lenya, who was the icon of Germany in the 20s and 30s before she escaped Nazism. And Fräulein Schneider is a key figure in the show in that she has the boarding house where most of the central characters live. And she's the ultimate survivor. And we meet her on New Year's Eve in 1929 in Berlin, while she's showing the young American leading man his room, for which he's told her that he can only afford 50 marks, and she wants 100 marks. And she says, you save 50 marks, I save 100 marks. I did want some 50 marks, why should that stand in our way? As long as the room's to let, the 50 that I will get is 50 more than I had yesterday, huh? When you're as old as I, is anyone as old as I? What difference does it make? An offer comes, you take.
Treasure on earth to be
very nice to go traveling to New York, London, and Rome. It's very nice to go traveling, but it's so much nicer. Yes, it's so much nicer to go home. It's very nice to go wandering the camel route to Iraq. It's very nice to go wandering, but it's so much nicer. Yes, it's oh so nice to wander back. Oh, the men are charming, the Latin lovers are sweet, but they can't compete 'cause they just don't have.
No more customs. Burn the passports. Right.
Have to wing it.